Well, toys unlike food, water, and clothing are not a necessity.
No, but 4029's Lauren Limerick shows us one local mom thinks sometimes toys are necessary, and she wants to make sure the children who survived the Joplin tornado have some.
Many consider toys a luxury, but for some kids, toys are a necessary distraction from reality. And although Joplin is on the mend, the psychological and physical impact of the tornado is still lingering, especially for children. That's why Amy Harrison thinks toys matter.
It's a necessity. Children, they thrive on their toys. They learn on the toys. It creates imagination. You know, everywhere we go, my little boy takes a toy with him. So toys are important to little ones. They're very important.
Harrison volunteered in Joplin a week after the storm hit.
It was heartbreaking. It really is. Especially the second day we went and volunteered, I remember seeing somebody carry out a little Tonka car, the old, you know, the kind with the little yellow roof. And my son has one, and it breaks your heart. It really does.
That's why she was inspired to organize a toy drive. And now big homemade boxes are sitting in local lobbies and hallways across Northwest Arkansas waiting to be filled up.
Just ask that, you know, if you imagine your own child going through this, what, you know, how it would affect you.
Harrison is asking for gently used or new toys for kids of all ages. Friend and coworker Kayla Head has already dropped off some donated goodies.
How do you explain to a five-year-old or six-year-old that you've lost everything?
Harrison says she just wants to make it easy for everyone to provide something, no matter how small, for the tornado's littlest victims. Lauren Limerick, 4029 News.
Good for her. Yeah. We've compiled a list of drop-off locations on our website, 4029tv.com.
And you have until Thursday to donate. Then Amy will take all the goodies to Joplin this weekend.